traffickers even in Europe, we had in the US, we had in India, of course, and all the developing countries around the world, India, Pakistan, we all have traffickers. Why I don't want to call them a trafficker here is because today they are extremely specialized. They do not just pick rags. They pick 70 to 80 different kinds of waste because the nature of our waste has changed so much. We are not just throwing rags in a landfill or in a dump site. We are throwing so many other things. And these are extremely specialized people. So we call them waste pickers or waste collectors or waste handlers. About why I'm qualified here to speak about them is because Chintan, for more than a decade, over a decade, I think the last 15 years, we've been working very closely with the informal recycling sector, by which I mean kudawalas, kabadiwalas, scrap dealers, reprocessors, the entire informal recycling sector. And I believe that the experience that we've gained in this time has allowed us to understand in great detail about how they should be included in the waste management systems. If you didn't have all these people who we so take for granted, our cities would be in a much, much worse state. So we have to pay attention to these people. In Delhi, if we talk about, there are about 1.5 lakh people who are working informally in waste. That means 1 out of every 100 person in Delhi is somehow connected with waste informally. 1% of the urban population. That's not a small figure. 40 to 50,000 people are only kudawalas. They are picking up waste at your door. So imagine there are 40 to 50,000 people in Delhi alone. And all over India, we have about 20 lakh people who are informally working in waste. Either they are collecting or they are recycling or they are reprocessing, whatever. It's an informal sector. And these people, because of the waste that they are handling, they are treated as trash. And it is you and I who are. We have videos on the Chintan website, if you care to see, which shows people saying, humko kya, hum inse baat hi nahi karenge. We don't even look at them. Our children will not interact with them. It's perfectly fine for them to come to your door and pick up your unsegregated waste and put their hands into all your sanitary waste, your diapers, your wet waste, your dry waste, whatever. That entire lot, it's okay for them to do that. One day if they don't come, it's going to stink. All that is fine, but you do not want to talk to them. You do not want to interact with them. You behave like they are invisible. So this is the lot of the people who are doing, I would say, a yeoman service in our country. In fact, it's not just in India. In developing countries around the world, name it India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Ghana, wherever, Africa, there are these people who have a vibrant collection in business, in collection, in trade, in recycling. Typically, these people have small businesses. They are self-employed. They have low capital investment. They use equipment which is quite environmental friendly. How many kudawalas have you seen going on scooters and taxis? They use a cart. They use a ready. That is the kind of transport which is completely non-motorized. So they are very environmental friendly in their work. But people falsely think that they are very very poorly skilled or they have very little technical know-how. On the contrary, they are very, very careful. They know exactly which material is valuable. If you see on the roads, if a kudawala is given a choice between a low-value plastic and a high-value PET bottle, he is not going to touch your low-value plastic. He knows exactly what is valuable and what is not. That is the reason that he is able to pick up so much amount of waste. Even hair is sold at, the hair which we just comb and throw off, it is sold at 1800 rupees per kg. So if this man does not understand waste, who does? So waste pickers, unfortunately, are the biggest people who get affected because of unsanitary working conditions. So if our city is dirty, our landfills are dirty, our dhalaus are dirty, more than you and I, they are the ones who get affected. Because they are the ones who have to work at they have to work with unsegregated waste, because obviously all of us don't care about segregating, and that includes me, of course. So they are the ones who are at the dhalaus, putting their hands into all this. They are the ones who get bitten by dogs, cows, you name it. The animals that you find at dhalaus or at landfill sites. They are the ones who get physical injuries in their hand because we do not segregate our waste. So whether he can easily get cut by sharps, broken glass, which we just throw randomly into our waste. So if a waste picker has... Every waste picker, you catch hold of every waste picker, any waste picker, he's going to have cuts and bruises on his hands. And if these cuts and bruises get infected by the blood from sanitary napkins or the or your diapers, he's going to get a lot of diseases. So it's very, very common. 80% of waste pickers have gastrointestinal diseases, respiratory problems, they have backaches, they have anemia. Anemia is one of the commonest. Because tell me, how can you eat after you've put your hand into somebody's trash? We have waste pickers. I have a waste picker. We work very closely with them. We have an association called Safai Sena, which has membership over 12,000 waste pickers. So there's this lady, Manvara Begum, who collects waste from Netaji Nagar, from about 300 households. She tells me, people are educated, but they don't seem to understand that if I open a sanitary napkin, which is not identifiable, because our manufacturers would not don't care about the extended producer responsibility rule, which says that there should be identifiable bags. So if I'm going to put my hand into somebody's sanitary napkins, I'm sorry, I can't eat the rest of the day. She's also a human being. So where are we concerned? First of all, there's a health issue with waste pickers in the work they do. There's also an affront to their dignity when we don't care to segregate our waste. So waste pickers are generally people who come from backward classes, migrant communities, you know, there are minorities, and a lot of women and children who are there as part of this waste picking community, and they are extremely susceptible to exploitation, repression, stigmatization. Because it's very common for them to be picked up by the police. Even the public harasses them. There are cases, we regularly go from Chintan, we are at the police station because some waste picker has been picked up, a woman waste picker has been picked up in the middle of the night. There has been no women constable, she's been beaten up, we've gone and had to fight and get her out of jail. So these are very, very common because they are the most marginalized of people who enter this profession. So when we talk about the speakers have talked about the policies and rules that are existing in waste management, solid waste management rules 2016, plastic waste management rules 2016. They are wonderful, they're extremely progressive, extremely comprehensive. They all talk about inclusion of the informal recycling sector in waste management. We think that our kitchen has to have Tupperware, we don't care about the containers that we get. I mean, I remember growing up, my mother was using Kisan jam jars as bottles to store lentils or, you know, rice or whatever. But now in my kitchen, why do I need to have Tupperware? Why does everything have to have plastic? Why suddenly have we forgotten all our traditional culture or frugal roots of circular economy of reusing and repurposing? Why do we need to keep buying new things all the time? We talk so much about waste management, but the first rule of waste management is waste reduction. Forget reusing, forget recycling. Just first decrease your waste. That has to be the mantra. And then we can talk about all the other things.